I asked for the talking dog. You beamed up these two also. Get with the program, people, and focus.
Sorry, Captain. The CIT is usually crowded with very keen students these days. It was difficult to log in on the dog.
Many pardons, Captain. These two students follow me around everywhere. It was difficult to move to an isolated location for you to transport me for our usual weekly briefing.
Captain to Transport Engineer.
There has been a transporter malfunction, Captain. I am calibrating. Just a wee second. There. The system has been corrected. Ready to transport on your command, Captain.
Good. Now Scotty, beam me and this farting talking dog to an isolated Earth location.
I, Captain.
Where are we? I'm so scared.
Scotty, I said beam me and the dog to a secluded place. Not these two as well.
Working on it, Captain. Just a few more seconds.
This place is so gross.
Get us back to the ship. Pronto.
Aye, Captain. Beaming you and your party now.
Finally. I thought you were lost to us.
So did I. Well, he beamed us to the sick bay. This is as good a secluded place to talk as any other. Even if we can't ditch your CIT student entourage.
Like, we want to be on your crummy starship anyway.
So, Captain, what is it you wished to talk to me about?
Underperformance management. As you can see, my crew are not performing to the expected standard. I need to manage this.
People underperform because they either have been put into job roles that require skills they lack, or have personal problems that impact on their work performance.
Yeah, or maybe they have developed a negative attitude, like failure to follow a lawful direction, or they lack diligence and motivation.
Judging by your demeanor and generally mean disposition, I would say that it is more of a case of your crew being victims of inappropriate behavior and being overworked.
They might even be sick. You can't perform when you are sick.
On board, we have the best medical facilities, as you can see around you in this room. As for bullying and overwork, you gotta be kidding me. As captain, I am both stern and fair.
For managing underperformance, it is important to develop a procedure. However, we must first ask ourselves whether the underperformer is getting clear direction and is trained.
Remember, you must not use the underperformance procedure to belittle or intimidate an employee. That would be bullying.
Thanks for the tip, short stuff.
An underperformance procedure should give support and assistance to employees to reach and sustain their performance at an acceptable standard. It must ensure that managers address performance issues as they arise. For instance, when to apply training or counseling.
Most importantly, they must ensure that the principles of procedural fairness are applied to processes and decisions involved in managing underperformance.
I get that, short stuff.
Well, you could have fooled me.
Hey, Alfie, tell her that it is important that the employee be informed a day or two before the meeting about its purpose and invited to bring a support person.
You just did, Alan. There are, of course, key points for employers to remember when holding the meeting.
This I know, dog. Firstly, I talk about the issue and not the person. I also explore the reasons why there is an issue, and clarify details.
Hey, you air, and you stay relaxed and encouraging, and summarize what was said to check the underperformer's understanding of the situation.
When working out a solution, explore ideas by asking open questions, emphasize common ground, and keep the discussion on track.
Also focus on positive possibilities and offer assistance, such as further training, mentoring, flexible work practices, or redefining roles and expectations.
That is very expensive medical equipment you are sitting on, dearie. Get off it. Now.
An awkward moment. Anyway, employers need to ensure the employee is aware of the task that is required of them, has also been shown what is required, and understands the gap between current performance and what is required. Employers should agree with the employee a plan of action for improvement. This plan includes strategies for training and career development, reasonable time frames for improvement, and the value and worth of the role being performed.
That idiot did it again. Sometimes the only solution for underperformance is a legal dismissal procedure. Scotty, get your act together, now.